Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to all of you to the Blub World Web Talks 98th edition. In the last 97 episodes, more than 1,000 school leaders have participated on this very platform, shared their ideas, opinions, observations, and what all new and amazing is happening all around them in the K-12 space, or to put it very simply, what's going on in schools. So, अभी तक के इतने इंटरेक्शंस में हमें बहुत सारे अमेजिंग से आइडियाज मिले, बहुत सारी इनोवेशंस पता पड़ी, और उनमें से कुछ सबसे अच्छी को हमने डॉक्यूमेंट करके करीबन दुनिया भर के 5500 स्कूल्स के साथ शेयर किया, विच इज नियरली 5500 स्कूल्स अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड। इस प्लेटफॉर्म का सिंपल सा मोटिव है कि हम लोग बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस, आइडियाज, इनोवेशंस एक दूसरे से शेयर करना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि अब वो शेयर करना आसान है, चीजों को इम्प्लीमेंट करना और आसान है, बिकॉज आज हम सब कनेक्टेड हैं, और जहां जहां इंटरनेट की मेहरबानी है और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर अच्छा है, उन सब जगहों पर बहुत सारी अमेजिंग चीजें हो रही हैं इन द कंप्लीट एजुकेशन स्पेस। दिस इज अ रेवोल्यूशन दैट वी आर ऑल विटनेसिंग, और शायद ऐसा है कि हम लोग हिस्ट्री अपने हाथों से लिख रहे हैं, जो शायद आने वाली बहुत सारी जनरेशन पढ़ रही होंगी हमारे आने के बाद। So before we start today's call, let me talk a little bit about Blub World. So Blub World is a magazine meant for teenagers. We work on a simple concept of teens inspiring teens. Har mahine hum duniya bhar ke bacche dhoond rahe hote hain jo kuch inspiring ya amazing kar rahe hain, and unki stories hum lakhon bachchon ke sath share kar rahe hote hain duniya bhar mein. Aaj hum aap sab se ye janne ki, ye samajhne ki, ye baat karne ki koshish karenge ki how do you think that the education space will evolve in the coming times, with our focus being schools, and to put it simply, education innovation. कहाँ लगता है आपको कि हमारे देश की या इस दुनिया की एजुकेशन जाने वाली है? कौन कौन सी इनोवेशन हैं जो आपने एक्सपेरिमेंट करी हैं अपनी स्पेस में? कौन सी स्केलेबल हैं, कौन सी फीजिबल हैं? और आपको क्या लगता है कि आपकी इंडस्ट्री इस पूरे सेक्टर को किस तरीके से इंपैक्ट करेगी, और आपका सेक्टर इंडस्ट्री को किस तरीके से इंपैक्ट करेगा इन द कमिंग ईयर्स? सो वंस अगेन थैंक यू सो मच एवरीबॉडी फॉर बीइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ द ब्लब वर्ल्ड वेब टॉक्स। अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। एंड बिफोर दिस स्टार्ट्स, इट्स अ बाइलिंगुअल प्लेटफॉर्म। आप लोग अंग्रेजी या हिंदी में से कोई भी भाषा इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं। इसके बियॉन्ड कोई भाषा यूज करेंगे तो मैं नहीं समझ पाऊंगा, प्रॉब्लम कोई नहीं, वो भी आप इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, बट ट्राई स्टिकिंग टू इंग्लिश एंड हिंदी, एंड प्रेफरेबली इंग्लिश, ताकि सब समझ सकें, हिंदी जब आपको ठीक लगे। दिस प्लेटफॉर्म इज अ टाइम्ड वन, सो वंस योर टाइम टू स्पीक इज ओवर, यू माइट गेट म्यूटेड। इफ यू गेट म्यूटेड, प्लीज डोंट गेट ऑफेंडेड। इट इज जस्ट टू फिनिश दिस ऑन टाइम, सो दैट नन ऑफ योर स्केड्यूल्स गेट डिस्टर्ब्ड, एंड दिस इंटरेक्शन रिमेन्स क्रिस्प एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर एवरीबॉडी। सो वंस अगेन अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम। लेट मी इनवाइट द फर्स्ट गेस्ट फॉर टुडे, will be sharing a perspective from an external point of view, not from the school, but looking at the school. Let me now invite Mr. Girish Nair, the founder and CEO of Curiosity Gym from Mumbai, Maharashtra. Girish ji, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio, and a very warm welcome.
Thank you again for that welcome. So a little bit about myself as an introduction to the audience. I'm the founder of a company called Curiosity Gym. And Curiosity Gym has been working with schools since the past 5 years on the topic that you talked about, which is innovation, right? So we work with schools and we set up innovation hubs in schools, because we believe that the way of the future for students is not learning in the traditional way of, you know, textbook learning and rote learning, but it's all about experiential learning, right? So we've all probably read about that, you know, many of the careers of the future are not going to be the ones that we grew up with. So as adults and as teachers and as parents and as school administrators, you know, what is imperative for us to do is make our students industry ready for the future, right? So what does that really mean? That really means that you have to impart the skills in the student to be able to think for himself or herself, right? And for that, you know, it is not So the whole industrial revolution of the past 100 years, it's been more about, you know, a knowledge economy and following the rules to have a better process for society. What's coming on is, you know, with the information age, and there's a lot of knowledge out there which is actually available to everyone at their fingertips. So what is important now is that ability to think based on knowledge that one has, right? And even if one hasn't attained the knowledge oneself, the knowledge is, and information is actually available to anybody of any age. the ability to think and adapt to different things is actually one of the skills that we, you know, is going to be really important for the coming generation. And that is where I think the whole education sector, I think there's a national education policy that has been recently released by the government, where, you know, and the whole thing that's going to be this thing is, how do you take that policy of experiential learning, contemporary skills, coding, you know, whether the sciences, the maths, the liberal arts, you know, giving lots of flexibility to students to choose that, choose their passion, but also be, you know, the ability to critically think and to solve problems is going to be really important. So the implementation of the policy is going to be some of the challenges ahead. And I hope the discussion today we'll all be talking about.
Thank you so much, Girish ji. To summarize what you said, you started with an introduction of yourself where you typically established innovation hubs in schools, because innovation or thinking capabilities bachchon ko dena ab sabse badi priority hai in the next coming years. Because one thing that we know for sure, ki single career lives ab shayad nahi hongi, ab multiple career lives hongi jisme multiple skill sets chahiye honge aur multiple thinking sets bhi chahiye honge, because aap apne aap ko adapt kar paaye, adjust kar paaye, wo itna aasan nahi hoga. So emotional intelligence and at the same time a lot of skilling will come in. And finally, jis baat pe aapne conclude kiya, the NEP getting implemented. So India mein at least education is a concurrent subject of the constitution. So central government ek policy banayegi, state governments us pe apna take aur apni policy fir banayenge, uske baad district administrations wapis se kuch banayenge, and finally wo shayad ek koi kagaz school mein pahuncha dein jis pe school koshish karega implementation ki. So what we know for sure is that the execution and the movement of this education elephant in India is not so easy. To wo hoga kaise aur jaldi kaise hoga is something that would be a part of the discussion for sure. But more importantly, hum sabse ye janna chahenge ki NEP to abhi aayi hai aur iska intezar hum bahut saalon se kar rahe the. But what do you think, have you already done, aur kaun si aisi innovations hain jo aapne try kari is lockdown mein aur jo aap abhi bhi try kar rahe hain apne teaching learning process mein? Let me now invite the next speaker for today, Mr. Sandeepan Reddy, who is the founder of Synergy Group of Schools from Ambajogai, Maharashtra. Sandeepan ji, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
So thank you, Daksh, for actually inviting us and giving us a platform. So my name is, I'll just give you a background. My name is Sandeepan Reddy, and our schools are in the small sector, tier 4 cities of in Bid district. आपको अगर अंबेजोगाई मालूम है तो इट्स अ स्मॉल तालुका प्लेस वेयर वी हैव टू स्कूल्स एट प्रेजेंट एंड 21 प्री स्कूल्स. द बेसिक एम ऑफ गोइंग बैक टू द रूट्स इज गिविंग समथिंग की एंड दैट इज वेयर हम लोग देयर वाज इंडियन इकोनॉमी. इफ यू सी द स्किल्स रिक्वायर्ड टू ग्रो एन इकोनॉमी इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट व्हाट इज टॉट इन स्कूल्स. सो what innovations, because we as vision of a school is like to develop a healthy, happy, inventive and responsible citizens of India. So that's the core of our school which we focus on, and for the last 10 years we have applied whatever we knew about what is required next. Like Daksh and Girish sir already said, okay, execution is a skill. Objective क्या था अपना? Like education का objective क्या है? यही पहला हमको सोचना चाहिए. जो Britishers का था, उसके बाद गांधी जी ने 1937 में नई तालीम का he set some parameters, and after so many years now that's a completely new policy. But in the given space, in the entire space, there are only four. That's what we call a 21st century skill sets. जो चार स्किल्स है वो इम्पोर्टेंट है, क्रिएटिविटी, क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग, कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स एंड कोलैबोरेटिव स्किल्स, एंड दैट इज वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इट टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल. नाउ आई कम अक्रॉस लॉट ऑफ ट्रेनर्स, और वो ट्रेनर्स अभी क्यों है? क्योंकि ट्रेनर्स आर नाउ ट्रेनिंग द कॉर्पोरेट्स. सो वहां क्यों ट्रेन करना है अभी? व्हाई डोंट वी ट्रेन इट एट अ स्कूल लेवल्स? व्हाट आर द स्किल्स रिक्वायर्ड? हम लोग अभी कॉर्पोरेट्स में टीम बिल्डिंग बताते, व्हाई नॉट इन स्कूल्स? So that came to my mind, and that's the reason I thought ki let's do something different. And the different part is being in a rural part, facing challenges, because there's a part like Daksha, it's a constitutional subject. State alag rahega aur center alag rahega, dono mein jhagda rahega, and we as private educators will be a sandwich between both of them. But there's beyond that. There's a lot of things we can go beyond there, like multiple intelligence. So that's the crux of everything. Every individual is different. So multiple intelligence is the core about identifying what am I good at rather than what am I weak at. Our education system abhi tak focus kar raha hai what am I weak at. Mera agar math subject agar weak hai to usko main tuition lagaunga ya fir mujhe pata nahi, but what am I good at and what are the opportunities. Like today nowadays there are 3000 careers which everyone can survive. Aisa nahi hai ki only 1% of the students are trying for medicine and engineering in top universities and others. So there are a lot of, so as educators we need to give an awareness to the entire, because we cannot focus on 2 or 10% of the student. We need to focus on the rest 90% of the student. And in rural part, that's the, everywhere it's a challenge, because parents ko jo mera khud ka ड्रीम वो अपने बच्चों पे देता है कि मैं खुद इंजीनियर है, मैं डॉक्टर है, तो समथिंग डिफरेंट है. वी पुश देम एंड वी डोंट आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट इज द स्ट्रांग पॉइंट. सो इनोवेशन में
थैंक यू सो मच संदीपन सर. द टाइम वाज ओवर बट वी विल ट्राई टू कम बैक टू यू अगेन इफ इट्स पॉसिबल. थैंक यू सो मच. टू समराइज व्हाट यू सेड एंड एज इज द ब्लिस ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी इन दिस कंट्री एटलीस्ट कि हमारे पास इंटरनेट का बार बार चैलेंज होगा. बहुत सारे लोगों के वीडियोज अटकेंगे, ऑडियोज अटकेंगे, बट ठीक है, दैट्स द वे वी हैव टू मैनेज. सो लेट मी समराइज व्हाट संदीपन जी सेड. संदीपन जी कम्स फ्रॉम अ वेरी यूनिक काइंड ऑफ एन एक्सपीरियंस दैट ही ब्रिंग्स टू द टेबल, वेयर ही हैज स्टार्टेड एज एन एंटरप्रेन्योर स्कूल्स इन टियर 4 सिटीज, रियली गोइंग बैक टू इंडिया या पूरे वैल्यू चेन के अंदर सबसे बॉटम एंड पे जाके स्कूल्स को इनिशिएट करना एंड वहां के इकोनॉमी और इकोसिस्टम्स में स्कूलिंग को एस्टैब्लिश कर पाना. सो दैट्स व्हाट ही हैज डन. एंड जहां पे उन्होंने बात करी ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ एजुकेशन हैज टू बी रियलाइज्ड, उसे हमें वापस एक नया हैप्पी रियलाइजेशन मोमेंट चाहिए एजुकेशन में, क्योंकि एजुकेशन का ऑब्जेक्टिव चेंज हो गया और इतना ड्रामेटिकली चेंज हो गया कि हम ये भूल गए कि वो एक मार्कशीट के बियॉन्ड हमारी जिंदगी को इम्पैक्ट करता है और उसको हमने सोचना ही छोड़ दिया. और एक बहुत अच्छी बात संदीपन जी ने जो कही दैट व्हाट एम आई बैड एट से व्हाट एम आई गुड एट, कि केवल इस चीज पे फोकस करना कि ये मुझे नहीं आता और इसमें से सीखने की कोशिश कर लूं, से शायद एक बेहतर अप्रोच ये होगी दैट आइडेंटिफाई योर स्ट्रेंथ्स एंड वर्क ऑन देम सो रिग्रेसली कि आपसे बेटर वो कोई ना कर पाए. सो दैट्स व्हाट संदीपन जी सेड. एंड एक चीज विच इट फाइनली रिलाइज ऑन इज अवेयरनेस. वो पूरे इकोसिस्टम ये नई तरीके की, क्योंकि पेरेंट्स अपनी ड्रीम बच्चों के कंधों पे डाल देते हैं. सो वी नीड टू नाउ थिंक ऑन न्यू अप्रोचेस टुवर्ड्स मेकिंग अ बिग मेंटालिटी शिफ्ट. एजुकेशन तो हमें करनी है, टीचिंग हमें करनी है, बट एट द सेम टाइम एक बहुत बड़ा मेंटालिटी शिफ्ट करना है. तो आपने अब केवल बच्चों को नहीं पढ़ाना है, बिकॉज अभी व्हेन दीज वर्चुअल क्लासरूम्स आर गोइंग ऑन The school size has quadrupled. क्योंकि अब क्लास में केवल एक बच्चा नहीं है, वो बच्चा है, शायद उसका कोई पेरेंट भी है, शायद कोई फ्रेंड भी है, शायद कोई कजन भी है. तो क्लासरूम इतने बड़े हो गए कि आप सच में बच्चों को नहीं पूरे समाज को पढ़ा रहे हैं. तो स्कूल कैन नाउ बिकम द इम्यूनिटी हॉटस्पॉट इन द कमिंग टाइम्स. और आप केवल इम्यूनिटी नहीं, सच में स्कूल के रियल ऑब्जेक्टिव या रोल पे वापस जाने का आपको मौका मिल रहा है, दैट यू गेट द पावर टू एक्चुअली educate the community around you. So thank you so much, Sandeepan ji. Let me now invite the next speaker for today, Professor Mumtaz Begum, who's the Dean and Head School of Education of Pondicherry University from Kalapet, Pondicherry. Mumtaz ma'am, over to you. Let's now hear from a teacher who teaches teachers how they teach. So over to Mumtaz ji, a very warm welcome, ma'am. Your video and your audio.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, everybody. This is a very august platform on which I'm to address about the school system of India. I'm so glad that we have made the school as the second home and home as the first school. That is the concept right now we are practicing. For the past 7 months, it has taught us a lot. The pandemic situation of COVID-19, we have learned a lot. Not only, the teachers, not only the students, even the common parent. even the so-called illiterate mother, that's what we used to designate people, the ladies of the home, but they are the best homemakers, where they try to capture their attention towards, especially on the kid. The kid has to manage his timetable as and how it is designated. This is definitely an innovation in the Indian system, and it is going to be a challenge also in future. Because how we are going to tackle this type of education? Will the children transform themselves from online to offline? Whether they'll be accommodating themselves? Suppose the children have been used to the practice of the classroom atmosphere. Suddenly now they are put in the home atmosphere. Again, they have to transform themselves. So it's like a practice of what we call blended learning. That's what we are forcing our kids to practice themselves. It is like when I talk about the system of education, It has come as a reality that the children learn from the surrounding, learn from the environment, not only from the teacher, not only from the restricted classroom. Practice a lot outside. Outside the classroom, learning happens. Learning is all the time, round the clock. It's 24/7 = 365, like that. It has made a drastic change in the home atmosphere, in the school atmosphere. The administrator is just keeping quiet as to what to do about the assessment, how to go about the assessment. The assessment practice, of course, has become online. And not only teaching, even the assessment, even the evaluation, the test and measurement, everything is going online. So that is a positive signature. India is marching forward in the global arena. And not that we have to say that India's it has far-fetched ideas and goals, and where it is matching its standard to, in the developed country in the world arena. That's what I must confess today. And we have in our university a project called Content and Language Integrated Learning. So the language being the medium of instruction or the mother tongue instruction.
Thank you so much, Mumtaz. You have a very important point to say, but the time is over. We'll try to come back to you where you said about language integrated learning. And this is something that has to be now understood with even much more vigor. Regional language, pre-primary, padhana has become a reality. And I think this is a very good step, because we are finally reclaiming our linguistic pride. क्योंकि अभी तक हम लोग जिंदगी में सबसे पहली चीज अगर स्कूल में कुछ सीखते थे तो वो कॉन्सेप्ट्स नहीं होते थे, वो सबसे पहली चीज होती थी ट्रांसलेशन, कि आपको इंग्लिश में पढ़ाया जा रहा है, आप उसे अपनी मदर टंग में ट्रांसलेट कीजिए एंड फिर समझिए, बिकॉज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी थिंक इन आर मदर टंग्स और आर रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस. तो दिस इज अ वेरी वेलकम स्टेप, दिस इज हैपनिंग. एंड यस, लैंग्वेज इंटीग्रेटेड लर्निंग पे बहुत सारा काम अब चाहिए, बिकॉज एज ऑफ नाउ most of the pedagogies do not focus on this. They focus on the much higher order skills and thinking sets, or this is much, much, much more required, because in early education, the biggest challenge that India faces is trained teachers. Hamare paas early child education ke liye trained teachers nahi hai, aur wo bahut bada challenge hai across the nation for schools. And ek bahut important point jis pe aapne sabka focus liya, the kids have to become transformers now. क्योंकि उन्हें पहले आपने ऑफलाइन से ऑनलाइन पे ट्रांसफॉर्म कर दिया, आप ऑनलाइन से ऑफलाइन ट्रांसफॉर्म करेंगे, तो बच्चा अपनी मेंटल स्टेट को इतना जल्दी चेंज कर पाए, अडेप्ट कर पाए, वो अपने आप में एक स्किल डेवलपमेंट होगा उसके लिए जो जिंदगी भर उसका साथ देगा. सो थैंक यू सो मच मुमताज मैम. लेट मी नाउ इन्वाइट द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर फॉर टुडे, मिस रूपिका टंडन, वाइस प्रिंसिपल अरुणोदय पब्लिक स्कूल फ्रॉम कड़कड़ुमा दिल्ली. रूपिका मैम, ओवर टू यू फॉर द नेक्स्ट 3 मिनट्स. प्लीज अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम.
Greetings to all the panelists, and I'm really happy to be invited on this panel. So coming directly to the point, we all know that for the past 2 decades, I'll say, the education sector, it has been invaded by technology. So with numerous apps, smart classes, WWW, which is World Wide Web, it has actually intruded our classrooms. We did resist initially, but you know, they have a sound reason why now we have to invite them, why we have to welcome them. The 21st century learner, number one, it on the click of the button, all the information is there. That means the teacher will not be the sole repository of knowledge. Second, which is most important, all these children, they have reduced attention span. So to retain their attention in order to teach them is going to be a big challenge. they have to face so much competition now that the world has shrinked. I'll say they have to compete with their other counterparts in the other world. But at the same time, opportunities increase. There are more avenues which they can explore. I mean, at our times, if we walked up and said, I want to be a hacker and take up hacking as a profession, everybody would have been flabbergasted. But now, ethical hacking is a 3-year full-fledged graduation course is there. So the artificial intelligence, augmented reality, virtual reality, all these are not decorated terms anymore. We are actually surrounded by it and we are using it. What we all agree is that every child is special. So self-paced learning is one thing that we all have to work on, and the innovations have to be that I need to reach that last child of my class. And through these online classes, I think we are able to, because every child is getting individual attention. If you, I mean, the child who was otherwise scared of speaking in the class or raising the voice, now you can pinpoint and you can ask. So differential teaching has to be there. In these online classes, the parent-teacher partnership has evolved like anything. And that is something we have been able to successfully do. And the parents are actually participating very willingly. Is one innovation that I'll say we have tried in our school and we have actually succeeded. Now, fortunately, the learning outcomes haven't changed, but the pedagogy has. The teaching methodology has to change. It is always said that a technology cannot replace a teacher, but a teacher without technology will also not exist. So as a good teacher, we have to blend all that is available to us.
Thank you so much, Rupika ma'am. The time is over. To summarize what you said, we started with tech innovation and uska resistance and finally acceptance, or acceptance bhi aisa ki finally it rules how we teach and the whole teaching learning process. But the way it changed the whole process was very dramatic, because just some days back we had a behavioral scientist on this platform, Colonel Sudeep Mukherjee. He shared a very recent research outcome that somebody who's trying to look at a screen like this and then trying to learn has an attention span of only 8 seconds. On every 9th second, he has actually started daydreaming or YouTubing or something else, because this is a big challenge. And सबसे बड़ा simile जो आप इस point पे arrive कर सकते हैं खुद भी समझ के कि आप अपने जीवन भर से you're mentally programmed that when you see at a screen you're looking at a celebrity because you've seen a TV screen. And जब आप किसी student से कहते हैं कि screen पे बैठ के पढ़ लीजिए तो वो एक celebrity को expect कर रहा होता है screen में, जहां से उसका teacher दिख रहा होता है. एंड वहीं पे उसका अटेंशन वैसे ही मेलो डाउन हो जाता है, बिकॉज टीचर्स हमारे देश में बहुत जगह इंट्रोवर्ट हैं, क्योंकि वी डू नॉट गेट द टॉप ऑफ द पिरामिड टू टीच, वी गेट द बॉटम ऑफ द पिरामिड टू टीच. एंड उसे एक वापस से एक एस्पिरेशनल करियर बनाना इज अ बिग चैलेंज, बिकॉज नाउ व्हेन यू नीड अ टेक सैवी टीचर तो सैलरीज भी उस तरीके की होंगी, फाइनेंशियल स्ट्रक्चर भी उस तरीके के होंगे, और एवोल्यूशन बहुत बड़ा होगा. बिकॉज एक चीज जो आपने कहा कि पेरेंट टीचर रिलेशनशिप बहुत अच्छे से एवोल्यूट करी, और हम उसे ऐसे कहते हैं कि अब स्कूल इज समथिंग विच हैज गॉन एब्सोल्युटली ट्रांसपेरेंट, क्योंकि आपका हर स्टेप कोई ना कोई देख रहा है. और अब आपको एक नया डिपार्टमेंट चाहिए, CRM, कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट, क्योंकि अब आपसे सवाल बहुत सारे होने वाले हैं जिनके आपको बहुत सारे जवाब देने होंगे. सो व्हेन द मॉडल इज एवोल्यूटिंग, हाउ डू यू थिंक टीचिंग लर्निंग विल स्टिल हैपन? लेट्स नो इट फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर्स कमिंग अप. Let me now invite the next speaker, Mr. Yashwant Vasudevan, Director, Principal, KJG Schools from Ooty, Tamil Nadu. Yashwantji, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
Thank you, sir. Like, since already you have introduced me, I just wanted to straight go into the topic. This is Yashwant Vasudevan. So here I would like to place on record two important points on how not to look at innovation. Firstly, we tend to consider technology as the only aspect of innovation, which is not true. And I agree that technology has come a long way and we have been largely benefited by that. But still, you know, like education innovation has major or significant areas to be focused upon. I would like to highlight two such areas. One is pedagogical innovation and the other one is leadership innovation. And the second point is that, you know, like how do we perceive or look at the process of innovation? We attribute the process of innovation to the corporates or companies or industries who actually hire smart people and the so-called think tanks, you know, like predict the future or try to predict the future of education, sit, design and innovate new products and resources, and finally get the patent, dump them, send them through the pipeline to the users and consumers. And if you look at these innovations, most of these innovations are static down the years. They remain static and then they don't actually materialize after some point in time. This is because, you know, like most of them are static, and we as educators should acknowledge that today is an era for open innovation and we should look forward for more of dynamic innovations than being static. And then, you know, like I just also would like to highlight that to facilitate more of customized and personalized learning, the big shift required as on today is from institutional structure to that of a collaborative structure, understanding the new power of collaboration. Education innovation should be built not upon the schools and institutions, but it should be built upon the community, student community, parent community, and teacher community. We should look forward to more of radical and incremental education innovation, allowing the users, the students and the teachers to become the producers and the consumers to become the designers. To conclude, I would say to reap the gains of education innovation, restoration of leadership from institution to individual student, teacher, and parent should take place, empowering them to innovate and adapt to new innovative ideas. That would be my recommendation to ensure education innovation into leading for us to get more efficiency and improved outcomes in quality and equality of learning opportunities. Be innovative. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Yashwanji. You took the discussion to another level and you added a completely new strata to it, that actually thinking on going by the word of it of innovation, ki how do you promote that and why is it needed, or wo keval technology nahi hai. When we talk of innovation, most of the people get stuck or get blocked at technology. Ki agar humne technology implement kar di, toh we have innovated or we have arrived. That's not typically the reality, because technology is just a tool. Wo us से ज्यादा होने की कोशिश कर रही है, मशीन लर्निंग इंट्रोड्यूस करके, एआई इंट्रोड्यूस करके, लेकिन वो अभी कोशिश ही कर रही है, वो अभी हुआ नहीं है. सो लेट एट दिस मोमेंट लेट्स ऑल फोकस ऑन व्हाट ऑल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इनोवेशन आर वी मिसिंग आउट. जी ने ऑलरेडी कही, देन इनोवेशन जो हम कर भी रहे हैं वो बहुत सारी स्टैटिक है, डॉक्यूमेंट्री है. देश भर के बहुत सारी यूनिवर्सिटीज हैं who are doing a lot of research. And most of the research remain in papers. वो thesis वहीं के वहीं bundle up होके bind होके रह जाती हैं, क्योंकि उसका industry implementation भी नहीं है, और वो बस ideas हैं. हम ideation कर रहे हैं, हम ideation को execution तक ले जाने की क्षमता हमने build की है ना हमने किया है. So this is something that we need to work really on, that how do you ideate and take that to execution. क्योंकि हम लोग corporate think tanks वो affordability रखते हैं कि इतने बड़े-बड़े R&D departments को fund कर सकें, but again they always remember the outcome of it. और हम when we have so expensive education structures जो कि government funded हैं, कहीं privately funded हैं, और हम research में input डाल के उसका output निकालना भूल ही जाते हैं. हम R&D केवल इसलिए बनाते हैं ताकि paper work पूरा हो जाए, उसके beyond शायद कुछ नहीं कर रहे होते. But now is the time, because a lot of redundancy has been taken away by technology, जो कि एक बहुत बड़ी सुविधा है जो technology ने सबको दे दी है, कि आपका administrative tasks कम हो गए हैं. So let's now focus much more on innovation and thinking and building something new. Thank you so much, Yashwanji, for adding that amazing perspective to the discussion. Let me invite the next speaker for today, Mr. Sampath Kumar, who's the senior principal of Mahindra Schools and Arts College in Namakkal, Tamil Nadu. Sampath sir, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
Good evening, sir. Hope I'm audible. Yes. Thank you. In the lighter vein, I would like to quote what Mrs. Mumtaz Begum was happily quoting. I was really very happy, but of course I would like to make a small, you know, point. Ma'am was telling happily, everything goes online. I'm very, very happy, because basically my teacher is English. I've been teaching English for the past 3 decades, something like that. But everything goes online. I'm very happy, but the children are going offline. Everything goes online. Everything goes online, but the children most of the time are offline. Because the other day I just was having a chat with my children, and as he was doing his second standard, I just asked him about your classes. Boring, Interesting. Okay, fine. Then what would you like to do? I would like to go back to school, sit with my students and teacher and learn. Fine. After some time, there was a bifurcation in the class. Morning one class and afternoon another class. So I just want to rephrase the question and find out the real feedback. Okay, you attended morning session and evening session online class. Which one is better? Come on, which one do you enjoy? I'm sorry, Baba. I don't enjoy both. I want to go back to school. So everything is online, but the children are offline very, very invariably. Well, what I want to tell you is, just imagine Monday morning, a big school, a very reputed school, the headmaster, the principal are sitting very, very, you know, like busy doing the morning course. A student who left the school after graduation, he came back to school to meet the principal after 10 long years, a decade. The principal asked him to come inside. Yes, how can I help you? Sir, I'm so and so, and I did my schooling there from grade one to grade one here at the school, and I'm very happy to be with you, sir. Fine, well, most welcome. What do you want? Sir, I've come here all the way, traveling miles together, because I just want you to refund the tuition fee which I paid right from grade one to grade 12. This fellow demands the tuition fee that he paid right from grade one to grade 12. The principal was really upset. And he told me, look, gentlemen, I'm very sorry to tell you that I'm very busy. You can't afford to play tricks on me. Why did you come here for? Tell me, come on. I've got a book. Sorry, sir. I'm very serious. I have come here only for taking the refund of the entire fee which I paid from grade one to grade 12. Then the headmaster somehow collected his strength and then just asked him, okay, fine. Let me ask you one question. Why do you demand the refund? Come and tell me the reason why you demand the refund. The answer which the boy gave, the one sentence which gives or which explains the whole gamut of education that's happening in our country. He says, sir, I want you to refund the amount because with this education, I'm not able to get a job, number one. So refund the money. Number two, in case I get a job, I'm not able to continue. So I feel that something wrong with the system of education given here. So kindly.
Thank you so much, Sampath sir. Children going offline, aapka apne pote ya apne niece ya apne grandson ya granddaughter ke saath mein discussion is very interesting, and that's typically the reality. Jo schools virtual classes mein kareeban 75% attendance ke saath shuru hue the, wo abhi 25 se 30% attendance classes mein dekh rahe hain across the nation. They have receded like anything. And children don't want to study online kyunki shayad hum bhi online nahi padhna chahte, bade bhi nahi padhna chahte, to bacche kya padhenge. And for children, you need an environment, because ek bahut important aspect education ka is environment, kyunki aap hamesha ek teacher se sunke nahi seekh lenge, aap shayad ek blackboard padh ke bhi nahi seekh lenge. Sabse zyada aap seekhenge experiences se, kyunki sab ye jante hain ki bacche apne parents ko copy karte hain, unki baaton ko sunke unhe zindagi mein implement nahi karte, wo aapko dekh rahe hote hain. So what they want to know and what they want to do is a lot of observation, which goes for a complete toss when it's a virtual classroom. Because here observation to band hai, keval listening or seeing chalu hai. To hamare keval do senses us age mein hame utni learning de nahi pate. So virtually teaching has continued, that's a sure, but learning is something where there is a question mark. Because uska jawab hum sabko dhoondna hai ki wo actually wapis resume kaise hogi. Thank you so much, Sampath sir. Let me now invite the next speaker for today. Dr. Priyadarshini Deoghare, who is the Director of Academics and Principals, the Achiever School from Nagpur, Maharashtra. Priyadarshini ma'am, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
Okay, all right. Innovation in education, we change, as they say, is the only constant in life. And this change came in so fast that we had hardly any time to adapt to it. But everybody has adapted and accepted the change. And everybody had to innovate. We had to resort to new ways of teaching. Learning, as you rightly said, we are not sure whether it is happening or not. But still, we have to think of ways. Because the situation is not in our hands, we had to innovate and find out for all the, like, how can we give the children an opportunity to learn the things. We can give them a near to real experience by using technology and showing them things online and then asking them to repeat it at their home and conducting live classes, which I know is very difficult for many of them because of many different issues. There are device issues, there are net connectivity issues, but that is what we can do the most. Innovation has to come in the form of teaching methodology. We have to use flipped classrooms. Earlier, when we were teaching the children on campus, we were giving them near to life experience. They were like you rightly said, they had the environment. But when the teaching has gone online, we have to tell them to prepare the things first on their own. And when they come to the class, we are having a discussion. So like that, if we give them an opportunity to discuss with each other and with the teacher, then their anxiety levels go a little down. And then their experience is a near to real world. Secondly, we have to have the approach of blended learning. A little of online learning and a little of things which they will be able to do on their own. So when we apply these two things, only then the education will happen. Otherwise, if there is a one-way dialogue delivery from the teacher, the learning does not take place. Like sir also rightly said, children are not interested in listening because they don't want to interact with what you can say, inanimate things. It is just like a small screen, somebody is talking and we are just passive listeners. So they don't want that. They want an interactive platform like we are having now. So I feel education can be done in an innovative way when we involve the children in live debates or interactions like this. Like you rightly said, this is now education or learning doesn't happen only from the teacher. There are various ways, like there's Google, there is experience, they're learning from the parents, but interaction is what they are missing. So we really need to innovate and find means so that the children are able to interact with each other. At present, it is not possible to let them interact physically. So let them interact virtually as much as they can and let them have a near real experience virtually as much as they can. Because that is the one thing which will lead them to learning. There are many tools available online with which they can have a, say, gamified learning is there, or other things are there using which they can have a little fun. So when the teacher asks them to ask.
Thank you so much, Priyadarshini ma'am. आपने एक एग्जीक्यूटर की तरफ से एक अच्छा सा पर्सपेक्टिव दिया एज अ प्रिंसिपल, जो कि आप हर रोज कर रही होंगी, बहुत सारा ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग, बहुत सारी एक्टिव लर्नर्स को बनाने का कोशिश. बिकॉज इन अ वर्चुअल क्लास द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज दैट वी फेस इज यहाँ पता नहीं पड़ता बैक बेंचर कौन है, क्योंकि यहाँ सारे फ्रंट बेंचर्स हैं, तो हमें पता ही नहीं होता कौन पढ़ रहा है, कौन नहीं पढ़ रहा है, कौन एंटरटेन हो रहा है, कौन एजुकेट हो रहा है. ये बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज हो जाता है डिफरेंशिएट करना. एंड उसके लिए ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग, फ्लिप क्लासरूम और चेंजेस जो एक्चुअली पूरे सिस्टम में हुए वो बहुत ज्यादा जल्दी हुए. And I think अब when we are teaching online, शायद थिएटर सारे टीचर्स के लिए एक सब्जेक्ट हो जाना चाहिए और थोड़ा थोड़ा नाट्यशास्त्र सबको पढ़ लेना चाहिए कि जहाँ हम वो नौ रस, वो भाव, वो भाषा सारी बातें सीख पाए. बिकॉज जेस्टर्स, एक्सप्रेशंस, लैंग्वेज, एवरीथिंग हैज टू फाइनली कम टुगेदर टू कीप पीपल एंगेज्ड एंड हैप्पी. बिकॉज एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज यहाँ पे फिर से ये है कि फीडबैक काम नहीं करता. बच्चे ने वीडियो ऑन कर दिया, यूट्यूब चालू करके वो बैठ गया, उसका चेहरा आपको दिख रहा है लेकिन वो आपको देख रहा है या किसी वीडियो को, ये आपको नहीं पता. और आपने जो पढ़ाया उसका फीडबैक तो वैसे ही नहीं आ रहा आपके पास. सो व्हाइल फेसिंग दीज चैलेंजेस, ब्लेंडेड लर्निंग इज समथिंग, बट आई थिंक द फाइनल सोल्यूशन कम्स फ्रॉम क्रिएटिंग एक्टिव लर्नर्स. जो संदीपन जी की बात मैं वापस कोट करना चाहूंगा कि लेट देम आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट दे आर गुड एट. वो बैड एट वाली लड़ाई को शायद छोड़ना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि अब क्लासरूम में वो जो फियर सर्किट था डिसिप्लिन वाला, टीचर की पर्सनालिटी वाला, दैट डज नॉट वर्क एनी मोर. नाउ वी नीड अ रिवॉर्ड सर्किट टू वर्क, कि अगर वो खुद पढ़ना चाहें तभी पढ़ाई हो पाएगी, आपके पढ़ाने से तो नहीं हो पाएगी. सो पढ़ाने से अब पढ़ने तक की जर्नी बहुत जल्दी और बहुत नए इनोवेटिव तरीकों से पहुंचानी पड़ेगी बच्चों तक. सो थैंक यू सो मच प्रियदर्शनी मैम. लेट मी नाउ इन्वाइट मिस पूजा Anjanikar, founder and principal Maven of Education STEMI School from Mumbai, Maharashtra. Pooja ma'am, over to you for the next 3 minutes. Please unmute your audio and a very warm welcome.
Thank you. Very good evening to everyone. It is really great to be with you all. First of all, COVID-19 hi kuch innovation lekar aaya hai. So, shayad innovation hum sab mein andar tha par chupa ke rakha tha kahin pe, which COVID has brought us back, and even children has adapted it very easily. अभी प्रॉब्लम यहाँ आ जाता है कि बच्चा इनोवेशन कर रहा है वो किस तरह कर रहा है, बाय लिसनिंग एंड डूइंग इट, और जस्ट बाय वर्चुअल एक दूसरे को हम जैसे अभी कम्युनिकेट कर रहे हैं बाय दैट वे. सो योर थिंग इज हाउ टू डेवलप द इनोवेशन फॉर द लॉन्ग रन एंड हाउ टू मेक दैट चाइल्ड टू ग्रो बाय द इनोवेशन मेथड इन टू हिज माइंड. सो सी व्हेन आई हैव द बैकग्राउंड व्हिच आई हैव कम, आई एम अ प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अ स्टीमी स्कूल विच ऑफ इंडियाज फर्स्ट वर्चुअल स्कूल. So that is also innovation which we have done, which where a child learns online but in a different way. How? I'll tell you why. When we give a child any type of tasks, bachcha tabhi sikhta hai, kabhi wo khud karta hai. When he understands it by his own, then only the child learns and learns how to do it, and then the innovation happens and the child is able to grow. So what we should do in term is that, rather than just having interaction of learning of curriculum, we can give break down those curriculum in the ways where the child can do something on its own. And chahiye hame agar hum kuch pre plan karke rakhe ki hum soch rahe ki answer iska ye hona chahiye, par kya pata bachcha innovate karke uska answer kuch aur nikale. So rather than becoming pre planned for the answers, we can be pre planned what the child, we need to give them the activity, उससे वो बच्चा सॉल्यूशंस निकाल के रखा है. सो एक्टिव लर्निंग कैन बी हैपन इन दिस वे वेयर चाइल्ड कैन बी मोटिवेटेड टू डू समथिंग ऑन इट्स ओन, रादर देन मेकिंग हिम प्रिपेयर्ड कि जो हमने तैयार किया है वही आप करो. सो दैट कैन बी चेंज्ड. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इज लाइक इनोवेशन मेन कैन हैपन व्हेन अ चाइल्ड हिमसेल्फ इज अडैप्टिव एंड हैविंग अ ग्रोथ माइंडसेट कि अगर मुझे ये चीज में प्रॉब्लम आ रही है, जहां पे भी इनोवेशन तब आती है जब प्रॉब्लम्स आती है. The child should know that how to tackle that problem, how to overcome the situation, and how to juggle with the problems and come out with a new solution. So, बच्चों को जितना आप अच्छे से critical thinking दे सकते हो या problem solving activities दे सकते हो, the child will able to learn more. Like now, how coding has come down. Coding is making the child learn to juggle with the problems, code up, solve the solutions, and come up with a new kind of innovation. So this way a child can be developed. So third thing which I could say is that let the child explore by its own, rather than you giving focus ki aap yahi karo. Let the child come up with his own questions and its own solutions for it. Yahi hum research mein bhi karte hai na. Aap PhD mein ek question lete ho aur uske baad fir uske upar research karte ho and you write down your solutions for it. Same, why can't the child do it in his childhood onwards? वैसे न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी में बच्चों को अभी बताया गया है कि यू शुड लर्न बाय योर ओन रीजनल लैंग्वेज, देन योर डाउट्स आर बीइंग क्लियर.
थैंक यू सो मच पूजा मैम. टू समराइज, आप यू आर अमंग द फर्स्ट वंस ऑफ कंप्लीटली वर्चुअल स्कूल्स वेयर यू आर गिविंग देम प्रोजेक्ट बेस्ड लर्निंग. क्या बार बार उन्हें नया चैलेंज देते हैं जिसको वो सॉल्व करने की कोशिश करते हैं, एंड दिस फाइनली you know, results into a learning outcome jo bachcha shayad apne saath mein le jaye. So when we talk of the process of implementing such things, we talked to more than 500 first schools that participated on this platform. At that time, the lockdown was absolutely up and sab jane apne gharon mein band the. So at that point, a lot of schools implemented this with a lot of vigor. There's one school in Bengal, I forgot the name of the city, they told their students to create a custom dictionary at home, that add 5 new words to that dictionary every day and bring that to school once the school reopens. There's one school in Sundarbans in Odisha, they gave an assignment, they told kids to create a wisdom diary, list what all good and bad did you do during the whole day, and this becomes your value education book because that's your wisdom diary. There's one school in Assam, the Springdale Academy, they started an activity to teach kids time management. They told them that create a balance sheet of time, consider time as money and create a balance sheet every day, that how much was spent on expenses, how much was investment, how much did you save, and how much is your time at hand. So create a complete balance sheet of your assets, of your time assets and your liabilities, So people have been really innovative. One school in Abu Dhabi started an activity where they called their students to cut a cartoon strip from whatever magazine came at their place and create a story around that strip. What you can see in it, that's one story. Give it a completely new story. So that's one more way of visualization. So people did amazingly during this time. There's one school in Singapore, they started something called a teacher's tea party, where every day morning at 7:30, they invited all the teachers on such a call and gave a solution to a problem that they faced yesterday. And then that solution helped those teachers every single day to keep everybody connected, emotionally bonded. And as an institution, the organization behavior was very positive. So, bahut sare innovations hue pure ecosystem mein. And we have heard all the speakers for today. The next 2 or 3 minutes is an open floor. Agar aap beech mein mute kar diye gaye the, aap kuch nahi bol paaye, if you missed out to something, you can now unmute yourself and speak out. The only thing, try to accommodate each other. So I think Girishji wants to speak. So Girishji, over to you.
I had a comment regarding the blended learning and the online learning and students being a little bored. I think the whole world is going, it's not only about India, it's going to go towards a blended learning model. The pandemic will at some point recede, right? Students are going to have flipped classroom, learn from home, learn from the school, all of that. When it is online, you know, I think one disagreement I would have is that, and maybe this is however being done, where we must make the lessons as interactive lessons. So just because it's online, you know, if like you said, the students have an attention span of only 8 seconds, then there's a big problem, right? So how is it that you still move the mode from a teacher one to many mode to a student being in the center, involve him or her in activities? So that's what in the even the NEP, they talk about experiential learning. Now, if you really go back to the NEP, how is it really going to be implemented in all of this? It seems like a great policy, right? But teachers will have to be trained. Teachers will be, we have to be given curriculum with these activities. Because if you ask them to run the household, run the kitchen, run the family and do all this new stuff, it's not going to happen. Okay, so I'd like to talk a little bit about implementation. The way it will implement, and this will not, and this I believe because of the use of technology, because of things on the cloud, the ability to have organizations deliver this thing on a platform that's available everywhere. Now with, you know, whether it's a Reliance or the telecom operators, you know, giving the infrastructure there, which is now the internet is potentially available even in tier 2, tier 3 towns, right? So infrastructure is being laid out by another industry, right? The, you know, so now everybody may have a phone which have this thing. So, you know, the consumption is this thing. And so then you can go into the self-paced mode of learning. We must have a robust teacher training program where it's not only about technological things. It's like you said, one of the other speakers said, leadership training, pedagogical this thing. You mentioned theater, you know, how to engage students all the time. All of these are going to be critical components of all of this.
Thank you so much, Girishji. Rupika ma'am wants to say something. Rupika ma'am, over to you.
In continuation with what Mr. Nair said, there's a short story which I find very relevant. The story is about a woodcutter who was on contract and he was felling trees. And then another person joins the same company and he compares his appraisal and he's finding that the other person is getting more appraisal. So for once or twice, of course, he takes it with bitterness. But then later he says that he approaches that person that, tell me, what are you doing special? Are you eating more or are you having nutritional diet or why is that you're getting more appraisal than me? So he said, I am always sharpening my axe before felling a new tree. So the skill set that we are talking about, the skills have to be replenished, have to be sharpened every now and then. I will not be able to pour from an empty cup. So if I'm talking about Zoom classes and I want to conduct it, I should be knowing what my children can play mischief with And this actually happened, you know, we gradually came to know how we can mute them, how we can stop them from annotating, how we can prevent them from chatting with each other. So it was more of online learning happening for us as well. So a teacher has to be a learner.
Continuous upskilling, and I think medical profession ki ek cheez hai jo teaching mein le aani chahiye, which is CMT, continuous medical training. Wo ab aapke teachers mein bhi honi chahiye, continuous certification karte rahe. Mumtaz mein wants to say, ma'am, over to you. Please unmute yourself. Mumtaz ji, please.
It's like I just want to pay my attention on teacher training. The teachers have to become learners, truly the learners. They have to push themselves into the shoes of the learners. How a child at stage of standard or eighth standard, what is his demand? So that it is like a demand and supply. Whatever they want, we have to replenish. We have to give. Not that I know so much and so I'm going to force on that. This is what the new education policy says. So act according to the whims and fancies of the learner. When the learner wants, start teaching. When the learner says stop, you stop, give a pause, and give them a life-oriented learning. The practice is such that you have to make the learner very comfortable with you, very compatible with you. It's like interactive mode and as a bipolar end. One pole you are there and the other pole you are learner. It is individualistic also. Don't think all the whole classroom into a consideration. It is the first student your attention should be concentrated upon. That's what I would like to focus on. In the teacher training, we've been doing like that. The teachers now know the reality exactly. So in the absence of the teachers also, the learning happens. So how does it happen? It is all within. The only thing is they require a facilitator, they require a mentor, they require a helper, they require a guide, they require whatnot. It's like a parent that they expect their ideas, as you said, no, from ideation to execution. They want themselves to be projected in the classroom arena along with their peers. And I'm so happy if the students want to come back to schools, that should be given more weightage because homecoming is always the best. When they come to the classroom, it's like exactly speaking homecoming, that they will learn a lot from their peers, from the environment, from the teachers, from their superiors, and the parents will know how learning happens in their absence also. Now the parents are thinking, only I'm teaching. When the teachers have given a module, I'm doing that. No, not that. It's the whole personality of the learner is concentrated by the teacher, by the parent, as well as by himself. So it's a peer learning also taking place. I'm seeing some of our learners just talking to their peer learners over phone. They try to learn from themselves. Hey, the project is given. Have you completed? How are you going to complete? So if you are having that point in your idea, then I will change mine. So like that, they try to transform themselves totally. So that's my view. So teacher training has to be given more due concentration. The teachers have to push themselves into the stage of learners. That's what is my suggestion.
Peer-to-peer learning, teachers' ka continuous upgradation is something that's very critical. And at this point, we all must appreciate the fact that teacher training ab bahut zyada critical ho jayegi, because there is an underlying paradox of education. Wo ek bahut aasan se vidambana hai jo education sector ke saath hai, that you get taught by a generation older to you and you teach a generation younger to you. So you are typically taking content, knowledge, engagement, and skills that are at least two generations old to your learner. So getting into his shoes is the most biggest challenge at this point. So Yashwanti has put his hand up. So over to you, Yashwanti. Koshish kare to finish it within the next 60 seconds.
And I just wanted to stick to this education innovation since that is the topic. And as you said, you know, like we come meet digital natives. When we meet digital natives, we should understand that education innovation has become the new imperative to bring about qualitative changes alongside the expansion of education systems. So for example, you take WhatsApp. WhatsApp initially was not meant for any professional, it was not a professional platform. Whereas later, you know, like if you deeply dive into that and you see like how many users of WhatsApp are there as on today, there are more than 5 billion people using it. And if you could see the reviews, there are more than 121 million reviews, out of which 44% of them have rated it with only one star, stating that WhatsApp is bad by giving their opinion, suggestions and all those things. And that is how WhatsApp has built them over the years. So likewise, any innovation for that matter, I personally wish that that should be in the alignment where children, students be the producers, users come producers and consumers come designers, and that would take it a long way.
Producers and designers, जहाँ पे हम actually changes या evolution जो है, वो finally user से लें और हम उसे थोपने की कोशिश नहीं करें. And one observation जो शायद आपकी बात से agree भी करती है कि जब इतने सारे education technology platforms और hardwares दुनिया जहान की कोशिश कर रहे थे education sector को impact करने की, जब lockdown आया, तो a company that worked the most, a solution that helped the most was not supposed to be an edtech platform, and that was WhatsApp. WhatsApp ने सबसे ज्यादा education enablement किया और उसका education कहीं कोई objective नहीं था. So thank you so much, Yashwant. Sandeepan ji wants to say something. Sandeepan ji, over to you.
So we have all the esteemed teachers and the principals on this platform. So my question is, now we talk about new normal. So post Diwali, when the schools are open, what would be the scene in the schools? So would technology be used, or then we come to the back to the basic? So just a
I would suggest it would be a kind of a hybrid platform, sir, where we have to
absolutely.
We cannot skip technology, but at the same time working on it, you know, like would help us. I mean, having technology plus, you know, like remote and virtual kind of learning together, a blend of it would work better.
जिन्होंने बड़ी अच्छी सी एनालॉजी कोट करी, अभी पूरा देश शताब्दी में चढ़ गया है. जैसे ही ये लॉकडाउन खत्म होगा, ये शताब्दी कैंसिल हो जाएगी और सब पीछे खड़ी हुई नॉर्मल ट्रेन में चढ़ जाएंगे और टेक्नोलॉजी को भूल जाएंगे. बट व्हाट वी थिंक कि शायद ऐसा नहीं होगा, एंड वी विल बी लुकिंग एट अ लॉट मोर एवोल्यूटेड मॉडल्स. बहुत सारे जने और बोलना चाह रहे हैं, बट द टाइम इज रियली ओवर. आई एम सॉरी दैट अब मैं और बोलने नहीं दे सकता, बट द टाइम इज ओवर. वी विल ट्राई टू कम बैक एंड लिसन टू यू. इफ यू मिस्ड आउट ऑन एनीथिंग, डोंट वरी, यू कैन शेयर इट विद अस ऑन व्हाट्सएप. Keep following Blab World on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, wherever you are, because we are sharing ideas from people all across the world. And these ideas, aapke kya pata kis jagah kahan kaam mein aa jaye. So before this talk comes to an end, a very small story from the real basic concept of Blab, from where we actually come from. A story of a girl who had her first painting exhibition at the age of 2, and it was a sold house. She had her second exhibition in a museum of New York at the age of 4. At the age of 6, she was invited by one of the most respected galleries of Europe for, again, a sold-out show. She's homeschooled, never went to school. She's somebody who earns in millions at the moment. She lives in Melbourne, Australia, and she's only 13 years old. And that's the cover page of Blab World, and that's Elita Andre. And that's the basic concept where Blab World comes from, that now teaching might not work, you might have to inspire them. Find out more and more stories, find out more and more engagement, find out more and more inspiration, because only teaching might or might not work. Because jaisa aap sab khud bhi dekh rahe hain, what we need is a lot of talking, is a lot of getting active. So let's inspire people, take teaching to the next level. So I hope you enjoy the last 60 minutes that you spent with us. If you did, and if you want to attend the future sessions, you can open your audio, say a big yes, and thank you so much for being a part of the Blab World Web Talks 98th edition. It was amazing to be with you. Thank you, people.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, it was lovely.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, people. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Okay. Bye.